question asked, can the prophets of Allah ever consider doing a major sin, for example, suicide?
Question says, can the prophets of Allah consider doing a major sin such as suicide? Perhaps this question pertains to what was asked a couple of nights ago about the narration that's quote-unquote in Sahih Bukhari, or supposedly in Sahih Bukhari, regarding the Prophet ﷺ intending to make suicide. Perhaps it is, perhaps it isn't. We say that we advised the one who asked the initial question to go back to Sahih Bukhari and read it again, if it's in Sahih Bukhari, that the Prophet was about to commit suicide. We say that Aisha radhiallahu anha narrated how the revelation came to the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Huh? She narrated, and there are people who narrated from her, the tabi'een who took this narration from her. And from those men mentioned in the isnad is Az-Zuhri, Muhammad ibn Ubaidillah ibn Shihab Az-Zuhri, the great alim from the tabi'een, who was from the sighar tabi'een. He was from the junior class of the students of the Sahaba. In other words, he met a companion or two. Everybody understand this? Az-Zuhri, you can read his biography, was a great scholar, a great alim, a great person of hadith. He only met a few companions, and he was someone who was well known for reporting things from people, whether he heard it or didn't hear it from them. He would make marasil, report things, and he would say, balaghana, it has reached us, we have heard. It used to be said, so on and so forth. Whether it was Aisha, whether it was Anis, another tabi'i, or not. Everybody understand this? In this narration in Sahih Bukhari that says that the Prophet ﷺ became sad and grief-stricken when the revelation stopped for some time, and he wanted to commit suicide and kill himself, etc., that's not from the statement of Aisha radiallahu anha. It's not what she said. Who was directly narrating it from who? Huh? Not directly from the Messenger of Allah. Aisha wasn't there when the Prophet was in Mecca in the early days. Aisha got it from someone else. If not from the Prophet, but she wasn't there. Everybody clear on this? To show you the depth of the hadith science. Is that for sure she didn't witness that what? That happening. There's no thinking or being afraid. That's the haq. Say it. She wasn't there. Khadija radiallahu anha, she was? She was there. Aisha did not witness that directly. So either the Prophet told it to her later on, or she took it from another companion. Everybody understand this? Let alone from the tabi'een. So Aisha didn't say that. It says that Zuhri says it has reached us that the Prophet ﷺ intended to do so on and so on and so forth. So number one, it's not the statement of the Rasul. It's not narrated from Aisha. Thirdly, it's reported from Zuhri, from the Balagat, the Marasil, the things that have incomplete isnads, clipped isnads. Who told Zuhri? Another tabi? Another sahabi? Was the tabi'i trustworthy? We don't know who it is. Two people missing, three people. We don't know. So therefore, the chain of narration of that report is not authentic, and that is not a hadith that you would say is in Sahih al-Bukhari. Imam al-Bukhari's book is made al-jami' al-musnad al-sahih al-mukhtasar min hadith Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wa sunanihi wa ayamihi. The title that he gave it was al-jami', the exhaustive collection. Al-jami' al-sahih al-musnad or al-musnad al-sahih that has four chains of narrations, which is mukhtasar, summarized from the hadith of the Prophet, his life and his affairs. So any hadith in Sahih Bukhari that does not have a full isnad, a full chain, is not the main purpose of Imam al-Bukhari's book. And you cannot criticize, critique, and take him to court for a hadith in his book that does not have a what? Full isnad. Those are other things that he offered in the chapter headings. He mentioned it here, he mentioned it there. But the title and the topic of his book is the hadith musnad, with a full isnad. And Zuhri was not a sahabi, he wasn't a companion. He says, balagana, it reached us, we heard, so on and so on and so forth. So that part of the narration is not, you won't say that it's what? In Sahih Bukhari. Even though it is, everybody understand this? It's what? It is what? In Sahih Bukhari. Everybody understand this? You come into my store and I say, this thermos is insured. This is the only product that's insured in my store. Anything else, electronics, is what? It's not insured. So you buy something faulty, you can't what? Because I told you that the thermoses were what? Insured. That's it. It's the only thing that I put my name and my guarantee on. Anything else could be good and it may not be. Everybody clear on this? So Imam al-Bukhari's book is made for hadith musnad, mutasil, with a full chain. And that report of Zuhri, the hadith of Aisha is in a full chain, but that part at the end is not with a what? Full chain. So it's a critical error and a scientific mistake to say that that report is what? Even though it is? Everybody, that's clear. That's first one. So therefore, the isnad of that hadith, that part of the hadith, is not authentic. And the meaning as well, as many of the people of knowledge you mentioned, is rejected. That the Prophet ﷺ thought of killing himself. Was he afraid? Hadith clearly mentions, Hatta khashitu ala nafsi. In Sahihain, he says, until I was afraid for myself. And Aisha radiallahu anha, she soothed him and consoled him. Kalla. She says, no, nay, rather, Allah will never disgrace you because you do this, because you do that, as we've studied. Khadija. Nah, Khadija. Everybody clear on this? Khadija bint Khuwaylid. Everybody understand this? So the Prophet ﷺ, he became a little afraid when the revelation came to him. But to say that when the revelation stopped, it says, وَفَتْرَ الْوَحِي. It was a fatra, a time in which the revelation had stopped. Was the Prophet ﷺ upset? Was he afraid? Was he scared? These ulama, they say, that he thought of committing suicide and throwing himself from a mountain. They say that's rejected, marfud, and that is incorrect meaning. That's the second point. Number three, we say what? Number three. We won't say point number three. That's enough. Wallahu ta'ala alam. Hopefully that's clear, inshallah.